But people on both sides of the aisle do not want to deal with this, and it is really important that we do. But who are the honest brokers of our day?
Too few of them. Too few honest brokers. I mean, some of the brokers in the on the right are unbelievable of late. Ever since this Trump thing blew up, I don't understand what's going on with, you know, like Tucker Carlson, Sean Hannity. With how do you, on the one hand, you bash, berate, and demonize Ted Cruz, and then on the other hand, how could Bernie Sanders not stick to his principles? How does he come out and endorse you, that is disappointing.
Did you hear, I've heard the Tucker Carlson, is this what you have?
Yes.
Is this what you were going for? I've heard the Tucker Carlson and I've heard the Sean Hannity. It is jaw-dropping.
Unbelievable to me.
And I say this as a friend of Sean Hannity's. I don't know how he sleeps at night. I really don't. If you listen to this, I don't know how he, and he's got to have some justification in his head.
I'd love to know what it is. I'd like to get him on and ask him, what's your justification for this?
I'd like to know what the hoop is that he's jumping through, because this is truly dramatic. And Reince Priebus is another one. Do you have the Reince Priebus?
It just got the Priebus in.
Okay, so Priebus is another one.
Talking about how Hillary's the nominee on false pretense.
Yeah, and how people need to vote in the DNC, how people need to vote their conscience.
When they
He literally said, vote your conscience.
Yeah.
That the delegates
unbelievable.
Have to vote their conscience, where last week he said he was the guy stopping the vote of conscience. It's amazing. That's nothing.
Listen to this.
I thought Ted Cruz, I think he blew it.
If I had been Bernie Sanders, I would have gotten up
what a gutless coward he was tonight.
Okay.
What a gutless coward,
Ted
Bernie
Cruz
Sanders.
Ted Cruz blew it. But Bernie Sanders is a gutless coward? After Ted Cruz stood against all the party leaders.
Establishment. Everything.
The whole establishment. And
the whole world.
Refused to, and didn't say anything bad about Trump.
No.
Just refused to endorse him. Just refused to go against his principles. He blew it. But Bernie Sanders is a gutless coward.
As I pointed out last night in the TV show, that because I said Bernie Sanders is going to endorse. But here's what Bernie Sanders said. If you listen to Bernie Sanders, what Bernie Sanders said was, she came to me and she brought me in and said, what can we do? And now we have the most progressive agenda in the history of the country. So he and his supporters, they were brought in. Now his supporters didn't want to go in. His supporters agree with Sean Hannity. He was a gutless coward. They are mad at him, and they are even more mad at Elizabeth Warren. But they both came in. So I agree. The one thing I could have always said about Bernie Sanders is he's a man of principle and he says what he means and means what he says. He proved Monday night he doesn't. He doesn't.
Right.
So he is a gutless coward.
But Bernie Sanders' speech at the DNC was the exact model Trump defenders were looking for from Cruz.
Right.
They wanted that exactly. Right.
Yes.
They wanted a guy who would come out, and I don't think Sanders was incredibly passionate about his endorsement, but he gave the endorsement.
Still said,
I stand with him. He did what he was told. He gave into the party and he did what he was told.
That's what Hannity said. He does what he's told. He does what the party tells him to, which is exactly what he didn't want him to do. But he did want Ted Cruz to cave in. And do what he.
I don't know how you make
that's
that.
That's unbelievable.
I don't know how you make that leap.
Unbelievable.
Because that says to me that one is only about politics.
And not only about politics. How do you sleep at night, but how does your audience let you get away with that?
Well, he was not. I mean, believe me, this was all over Twitter. The same people who were critical of Cruz were absolutely as critical of Bernie Sanders for doing what they wanted Cruz to do.
I've had two very large media people who I have not been on with, very large media people, say to me off air, I cannot believe you. And I'm like, well, why? I'm telling you. No. I know you are. I just can't believe that out of everybody that we have trashed over the years and is a populist in our eyes, that you are the one who's not the populist.
Because
you're the one. They all expected at the convention for people like Ted Cruz or people like me or Eric Erickson or Ben Shapiro to fold.
To just cave.
Yeah. Right.
And to be the cowards.
They cannot, the media cannot compute that. They're like, wait a minute. Even our side is doing that, and we know that it's, you're a spineless coward. They disagree with Bernie Sanders, but they want to win.
Ted and Tucker Carlson did the same thing.
You don't endorse Trump, you don't want to be with Trump, don't show up. Bernie Sanders turned out not to be a revolutionary, but an obedient little party guy who does what he's told. And so
you,
how sad
he was wrong to do that?
Well, I think he betrayed the ideals of the people who supported him, and I think he revealed himself again, not as a free thinker or someone who's bigger than politics, but as someone who's just a puppet of people in power.
It's not like one of these things happened 7 years ago,
right,
and the other happened last week or this week.
What,
one happened last week, one happened this week.
And it's the same. It's exactly the same.
Exactly.
And they're both saying, Tucker Carlson, I heard him on Monday saying, if Bernie Sanders, if Bernie Sanders endorses Hillary Clinton, it's going to be a nightmare. I'll have lost all respect for him.
What?
What? And we know now why. We know now why Tucker Carlson was the one leading the way against me at Facebook. Why he was the guy who took it on to be the anti-Glenn guy at Facebook.
Oh, no.
Because he's clearly just a party guy. And he was one of the guys who said, you know, maybe we should have quotas at Facebook. Maybe we should count the number of conservatives and you should balance your staff out with conservatives.
Yeah, because conservatives love quotas.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's crazy.
I mean, I cannot come up with a defense for Tucker Carlson on that.
No.
I mean, if you want to give Sean Hannity the benefit of the doubt here, you could say that Sean, you know, I think Sean legitimately likes Trump.
Oh, he does.
He legitimately likes him.
He legitimately believes in Donald Trump.
Yeah.
And so he said to me, I don't know why either.
Right.
Never. He has been honest with me on that. He's like, Glenn,
yeah,
I know him. He's not the guy you think he is.
And I think
so he's been legitimate, at least to me, he has said, I like him. I trust him. And right. So he's at least being honest on that.
And I think maybe he's, you know, the ends sort of justify the means. He thinks that the Trump presidency would be so much better than a Hillary presidency,
he absolutely does.
He absolutely believes that. And so, you know, we need to make sure that this happens. And the best available argument at both of those times was Cruz did something bad and Bernie did something. Bernie did something bad by not going.
I don't know how you do that.
But I mean, I think that's probably what he's thinking. He really thinks it's important Donald Trump wins this election.
Well, yeah.
So he's doing whatever he has to do. But
you don't have to do that. You really don't have to destroy the other side. You really don't. You don't have to. The smart thing to do is try to invite the conservatives in, especially if you have the ear of the guy to say, look, don't. Donald, don't do that. Just, he said, support the constitutionalists. He could have easily gone on and said, hey, what he was saying was support the constitutionalists. I know Donald Trump is the guy.
Right. And I think, honestly, this has been turned into this big moment of standing up for Ted Cruz. And I think it was very difficult to do. To have a personal conversation with Donald Trump, to tell him you're not endorsing him, to go in front of that crowd knowing you're not endorsing him, to feel the pressure of people chanting endorse Trump and not endorse him. All that's very difficult. But the words in the speech themselves were very tame. I mean, to say that a party would boo you for saying vote your conscience is not something seen before in American history, as far as I know.
Oh.
I mean, that's always been, even if you don't believe it, something you say.
Being booed when you say support the person who has constitutional convictions.
Right.
Pretty bad.
Julie,
I don't know if you heard this. Mark Madsen, he's a senator from Utah. Utah is gone. Utah is gone from the Republican Party. I mean, I don't know how Orrin Hatch and his ilk survive because...
He always does.
I know.
500-year-old cockroach.
Listen to this. Mark, beautifully put. Mark Madsen said yesterday, every decision and inclination I have had was reinforced at the GOP convention. I am going to become a libertarian. He said, the current direction of the party makes me want to cry. I have invested a lot in that party. And that's really the problem. We're all investing in a party.
Yep.
Stop investing in a party.
Best in the country.
In principles.